Hi, this is episode 2 of setting up Writer in LibreOffice. So in the last episode we talked about tools, user data, how to use this info in the document, general, how to change some things, how to use this to change the look and feel of LibreOffice, how to reduce the print data in when printing in LibreOffice, how to change the path to some files, and also how to deal with when importing a document with a font you don't have in LibreOffice. For example, here if we want to use if you have, for example, a document with Times New Roman and we don't have Times New Roman, what we can do, we have this file test, and in fonts we check this apply replacement table. You can see in option fonts, so now it's inactive. You can add something. You have to check this apply replacement table, and from here you can insert, for example, times with a font, for example, like Serif, Sans, or Mono. This way you will have always a compatible font to use in your documents. And Arial to be replaced with Sans, and so on. Now let's talk about security. We have this option here, security warnings. For example, this is warning you when the document contains changes, versions, hidden information, or notes. Let's check this. Okay. When saving, we will test this when saving, and let's insert a comment from here with some text, and let's try now to save. Oops, we have this warning: this document contains notes. Do you want to continue saving the document? If we are very strict with our security, we will give no. Delete first the comment if you don't need it. And now, if we save, we don't have this warning. The same thing is with version and other changes. Let's uncheck for the moment. This option, I don't seem to work. Maybe I'm making something wrong. Let's uncheck for the beginning. We have some personal information in here, in file properties. In description, for example, I have this title, secret title, secret subject, and secret keywords. Okay, and another information about me, I can complete here, for example, my name. Okay. And if you go to security option, this is remove personal information on saving. So we just need to save this document, and I save it, and let's check user data. My info is here, and file properties, our info is here. I don't understand exactly. And when I printing as a PDF, and let's check this test PDF, what information it's containing. It have a secret title and a secret subject, so it's not okay to send those information. If we check in security not to send our personal data, personal information. Another check is to ask for password. doesn't seem I am saving now and not asking for a password. I don't understand what is doing this. I'm writing something to be not working. Maybe not. I'm not using this in the right thing. Now this is control click to follow a hyperlink or just click to follow a hyperlink. So let's test now the default version. I transform this in a hyperlink. I select this text and click here hyperlink, and I'm writing a website. Okay, and if we hover over this, we have control and click to follow the link. And let's test. We press the control and we can open the website. Now let's go to tools, option, security, and uncheck this. Now we just hover and we have click to follow the link, not control. We can't edit this text. If I want to edit, I risk to click the link and it opens in the web browser. So I prefer the default version option and check this. Also, we have block any links from document not among the trusted location. So let's continue. We have also macro security. When you run some macro in the document, you first add a trusted certificate from here. You add the certificate, and after that you check this very high security level, just that macro to be trusted. If you don't, if you want any macro to run, you can check this or this in order to run. As personalization, you have a change of theme. You can see in the top we change the look of the that part of the LibreOffice. I don't like this, and so I prefer the default look. It's much better. Maybe this is a bug. Just the top is changing with that color. I don't know. So let's go over there to application color. Let's test this. For example, I write some text here, and I make this a little bigger to see better. The text is automatic and we want a bigger font. So now let's go to tools and application color. Let's change, for example, the grid. You can see we have some dots in the page. I make them red. They are very little point over there. I don't know if you can see them, but let's make automatic. Let's change now document background. Let's choose black. So in this way you can see now the dots. Let's hide them. So LibreOffice is make for this could be used when working in the dark, in the night. You can use white text on black background, and automatical LibreOffice changing the text color to have a better contrast. Let's check this with another color. The text is black and the background is green and brick and so on. We have some contrast here, so we can read and write the text. Now let's check the boundaries. So we have this sign here where the text is beginning. I prefer something like this to be easy to see. So if you go over there, let's look at table boundaries. Let's insert a table first to see better. A little table, and let's have the borders over here, and over here I don't want any border. So you can see in the top is not border, and in the bottom we have a border to this cell table, table of the cell of the table. So let's change the table to something light. You can see I can barely see the table border because it's here, but it's very easy to see that this is the margin, the border, but will be not printed. If you check this to a darker color like black, we can make a difference between existing and not existing border. If we print, we can see that we don't have border, but in reality we don't see this. So we need a lighter color for not for object but for table. So this is more useful. You can see that how the table will be printed. We can change the font also, and so on. We have many many fields we can change to be our taste. Let's go further to accessibility. This is very useful, for example, when we use high contrast mode in the operating system, and we have to check this, and automatic font color for screen display, and the text selection, cursor, and read only mode to be different. So these are some tests. Let's go further to option. At advance we have here experimental feature and enable macro recording. For example, first let's see how is without this user interface. We have standard, single, sidebar, tab, and group bar, 5. Let's go now to option, enable experimental feature, apply, and restart LibreOffice. Save the document, and it opens again. Let's go now to view, user interface, and we have more than 5. We have some experimental feature that you can test even this is a stable version, or you can see what is working on in LibreOffice with this experimental feature. So for the moment I uncheck this, and here we have Oracle Corporation Java runtime environments. We can check this, what version do we want to see. Let's uncheck enable experimental feature. Here we have for LibreOffice basic IDE. You can check some option here also for the LibreOffice updates, when to check for new versions. This is what information LibreOffice get from you, so it's very useful to check this, and so on. So I hope you like this LibreOffice setting today. This is 6.5 version, and I hope you learn a lot about this. You can check with options, advance, and enable experimental feature. You can test these interfaces LibreOffice is working on. Please subscribe, and thanks for watching.